Students, in this session, let us solve one problem on force coupled system. So let us read the question. System of parallel forces are acting on a rigid bar as shown in the figure. So it's a bar AB. So here parallel forces are acting. All the forces, line of action, are parallel. So here four forces are acting on it. So it is shown in the figure. Reduce the system into three parts they are giving. Reduce the system. So here four forces we have to reduce into a single force. In the second part, we have to reduce into a single force and a couple at A. And third part, we have to reduce it to a single force and a couple at B. So, okay, how to solve this? So, here, reduce the system into a single force means they are asking us to find the resultant. That's it. Okay, we need to find the resultant. So, resultant means a number of forces acting on it means it can be converted into a single force. That single force is the resultant force. So, we have to convert the resultant. We have to find the resultant force. So, how to find the resultant of the force system? So, here resultant means we have to add. So, here all the forces are parallel forces. Parallel. Upward and downward forces are there. So, for finding the resultant, just we have to add. Okay, there is no horizontal force, only parallel force systems. So, upward force means we give positive. Downward means negative. Upward, positive, negative. So finally we get minus 60 Newton. That means the force is acting downwards. We are getting minus, right? So force is acting downwards. So we converted. So I put equal, right? So these two are equal. So here four forces are there. So here I converted into single force, resultant force. These two are equal. Okay. But here in this we have to find x, at what distance the resultant force should act. Okay, we have to find the location of the resultant. So I am assuming that it is acting at a distance x from the left edge A. So unknown value, I am assuming it as x. So I have to find the value of x. Okay, for that we use momentum principle, isn't it? For location of the resultant, we use momentum principle. So here for location of the resultant force, what I am doing is, so I am going to find the algebraic sum of moment of all forces about a point A. So sigma ma, sum of all moments about the point A. So consider this diagram. Here I am going to find the moment about the point A. So here A point. At the A point it is going to hinge. As like we are assuming. So here four force, moment will created by the force. Here by the force 13 Newton, there is no moment because no distance. Because we are going to find the moment at A, we are holding at the point A, it is hinged at the point A, and at the point I am going to apply a force. Due to that force, there is no rotation happens. No distance is there. So go to the next force, 150 Newton. So this is a downward force. It is kept at center point is A. So it is acting downwards. So at the center point is A, the downward force makes the body to rotate in clockwise direction. So I put plus force into perpendicular distance. Force value is 150. Distance of the force from the fixed point, right? This distance, force from the fixed point, 50 Newton acting at a distance of 1 meter from the hinge point A. So 1 meter. Then consider 70 Newton force. So this 70 Newton force is an upward force, right? Upward force. So it is hinged at point A. Due to the application of this upward force, the body will rotate in the direction of anti-clockwise direction. So I put negative sign. So the force value is 70. And the distance of the force from the fixed point is 2, right? 1 plus 1 gives 2. So, the distance of this force from the fixed point is 2. That's all. then comes to the next force 10 newton. This is downward force. Downward force will rotate in clockwise direction. So plus the value is 10 into distance of this force from the hinge point is 3.5. So we got 45 kilonewton meter. That's all. Then come to the moment by the Varignon's theorem. So algebraic sum of moment of all in the forces will be equal to the moment of the resultant about the same point. So here resultant force, only single force, this force create moment at A, right? So here also hinge at A, this downward resultant force will rotate in clockwise direction, so it is plus. So the value is 60 into distance of the resultant force from the hinge point is unknown value, which is x, 60 into x. Just we equate the moment value, so we will get the value of x as 0.75. So we found the location of the resultant. So if this is 0.75, this distance is 2.75, because total distance is 3.5, this distance is 0.75, then remaining distance is 2.75. So now we convert first part, we find the answer for the first part. We converted the force system into a single force, that's all, which is acting at point 0.75. These two are equal. These two gives same effect. Now, our question is, we have to convert this force into force coupled system at A, right? So here, we have to convert this force into force coupled system at A. So here the force is acting at the point here only, okay, at a distance 0.75. That's all. We have to move this force from this point to the point A. So while moving, what it happened means, while moving a force from one place to another, one couple will be created. Okay, so just we have to understand. So our question is, we have to convert into a single force and a couple at A. So we have to move this resultant force to the point A. So how I am moving means, just we see this diagram. With this diagram, we will understand very clearly. So here one single force, right? Here one single force is acting, right? Single force is acting at a distance of 0.75. Now the question is, we have to move this force to the point A. So I am applying two forces, one downward, one upward force at the point A. Okay, so due to the application of these two forces, no change in the system, because so here upward force is 60, downward force is 60, the total sum is minus 60 plus 60, the total sum is 0. It has no change in the system. So just I am applying at a point A, so I am applying one upward force and downward force. Now you see this upward force and this downward force acting at a distance 0.75, which constitute a couple. So here this 60 newton, this downward 60 newton. So upward and downward, two parallel forces acting opposite side, one upward force and a downward force acting at a distance 0.75, so it forms a couple. Okay, so this couple have a moment 60 into the distance only, single force is 60 into distance is 0.75, will get 45. Which direction it will rotate in? Clockwise direction. So this two forces can be converted into a single couple. Okay, couple at the point clockwise, the couple. So remaining, so we already used this couple, this 60, so we already used, which is converted into a couple, clockwise couple at value is 45 newton meter. So remaining 60 newton force is here. Now so compare the first diagram and third diagram. So what it happened means, here the force is applied at the point here. So I am moving this force to the point A. There what it happens, it includes one couple also. When I am moving a force from one place to another, it gives one couple also. So how I created means at the point I apply two equal and opposite forces. So one force is used for making a couple and another force will remain. So this is a value. Then the next question, they are asked that we have to convert this system into force coupled system at B, right? So we have to convert this into a single force and couple at B, right? Couple at B. So actually the force is acting here. Now our aim is to transfer this force to the point B. So already we transferred to A. Similarly, we are going to transfer it to the point B. So at the point B, the same like one up, downward and upward force I put. So by applying these two equal and opposite forces, no change happens in the system. Now this downward force, this upward force acting at a distance 2.75 meter will constitute a couple. Which couple? This couple will have a rotation in anti-clockwise direction. The value of the couple is 60 into 2.75. The value is 165 Newton meter. So rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So just I replace these two forces acting at a distance into one pure couple. The value is 165 Newton meter. Now the force is 60 Newton acting here. So now I transferred the 60 Newton force here. Now it adds one couple also, anti-clockwise couple also.